Syria's president and his regime.
Syria's turmoil crossed an important threshold when the International Red Cross formally declared it as a civil war. The casualty tallies continue to climb higher as fighting rages across the country. Hundreds of thousands are fleeing Syria, seeking sanctuary in refugee camps in neighboring countries. The death toll now exceeds 100,000. Special advisor in St. Lucia's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Vaughan Lewis, has expressed concern over the conflict and its impact on small island economies. He fears that if the conflict continues to escalate, oil prices will skyrocket and affect St. Lucia's prices, especially at the pumps. These concerns come at a time when St. Lucia has already had a number of increases in fuel prices.
Of course, when these events occur, and they're occurring in the Middle East, and involve the great powers, the concern of our small countries, of course, is that the economies get affected, and particularly, of course, in relation to the price of oil. Middle East, of course, is one of the major sources of oil, and we are would have to be very concerned that the eruptions, difficulties and disturbances in the area might well send the price of oil up. And that is something that we would want to be very wary and concerned about.
However, Dr. Lewis believes it is difficult for people in this part of the world to understand what is fueling the conflicts in Syria. He said nations in the Middle East are made up of a wide cross-section of ethnic groups with their varied individual ideologies.
Well, of course, I think small countries like ours would always depend on the assessments made by the United Nations and the Security Council in dealing with matters of this kind. And really, as you know, all those things are proceeding on the part of the United States and others. And the fact of the matter is that there is a mission that has been sent there by the United Nations to make an assessment on the matter. And I think, speaking personally for myself, one would expect that there might be a waiting in order to get the opinion of those who have been designated to study the problem and examine the problem.
Dr. Lewis is hoping that at least for the sake of small island economies like St. Lucia, the situation is brought under control. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.